And welcome to PECOS. In this demonstration, we're going to show you how to log into PECOS and revalidate one of your Medicare enrollments. In this example, we'll be performing the revalidation on an application for an individual practitioner, but the screens and steps are very much the same even if you're performing a revalidation for an organization. To start, we're going to have to log in, so go ahead and pull up the login credentials you used when you first submitted your application. If you have any questions about your login credentials or need further support, go ahead and use the Forgot Password link shown here or the Manage/Update User Profile link below it. Note that if you don't have PECOS login credentials, please visit the PECOS homepage for more information on how to obtain what you need. I'm going to go ahead and log in now.
Entering user ID and password. Selected Login button.
After logging in, you'll be navigated to this welcome screen and you'll want to select the My Enrollments button to move forward. Because we're performing a revalidation and this is not just a brand new initial enrollment into Medicare, you'll select this View Enrollments button shown here. You'll then be brought to this My Enrollments screen and you'll want to scroll down to the bottom of the page. In this example, Jenny Lewis is a practitioner working in internal medicine and needs to revalidate. But if you log into PECOS yourself and you don't see your current Medicare enrollments listed here on this page, you'll still need to revalidate if you received a notice to do so. So to do this, just submit an initial enrollment. You'll need to click on the New Application button shown on the previous screen, and then this submission is what will count towards your revalidation for which you received the notice in the mail. And if you look on the screen here, you'll see that the revalidation notice sent for this example was sent on 10/15/2010. And I can go ahead and select this Revalidate button that's immediately on the screen shown here now to begin this process. You'll then be brought to the Confirm Reason for Application screen, where you'll see your reason for submitting an application in Medicare shown here as a label, and you'll want to confirm that this is accurate before continuing. So because we are revalidating in this example, this is shown accurately, and I'll scroll down to the bottom of the page and select this Start Application button to continue. Next, you'll be pulled into your enrollment application itself, and you can easily navigate within your enrollment using these tabs at the top of the screen shown here. I'm going to select the Topic View button to see what my enrollment looks like. And scrolling down on the page, you'll see that in this example, a number of these topics have already been completed and have check marks associated next to them. If you log in and some of these topics here are missing check marks, you'll need to address those and complete them before you can move forward. Note that if you're submitting a revalidation, you can make any updates to your application that you need at this time, and you do not need to submit them as separate enrollment updates to Medicare. So for the purpose of this example, I'm going to go ahead and make an update to the contact person telephone number. Here you'll see that you can edit or delete this information, and you can use the Add Information button as well if you need to add an additional contact person. I'll select the Edit button here, then the Next Page button, and then I'll update the telephone number to be the new accurate one. After doing this, I'll hit the Save button at the bottom of the screen. And then I'll select this Review Complete button once I've reviewed the contact person information and confirmed that it's accurate. And now that I've updated my telephone number to this new one, I'll select the Review Complete button. I now can navigate back to the Error Check tab, and as you can see, there are no errors left for this enrollment application. I'm now going to navigate to the Topics page by selecting this Topic View button at the top of the screen. And if I scroll down all the way to the bottom of the page, I'll see here that this Begin Submission button is now enabled. So again, if any other updates need to be made to your enrollment application, you can do so during your revalidation submission. And because the only update I needed for this example was the contact person phone number, I'm ready to begin the submission, so I'll select this button now. After selecting the Begin Submission button, the first page you'll be brought to is the Electronic Signatures page, where you'll be prompted to designate whether or not you'd like to electronically sign any of the documents shown on the page, so in this case it's a certification statement. Choosing to electronically sign the documents shown on this page means that you will not need to mail a hard copy to your Medicare administrative contractor. So I'm going to go ahead and select yes, that I do want to electronically sign, and I'll select the Next Page button to move forward. You're then brought to the e-signature submission page, Well, you'll be prompted to review all documentation prior to e-signing, and then you'll need to accept the terms and conditions for whatever documents you are electronically signing. So in this case, after thoroughly reading the certification statement for individual practitioners' terms and conditions, I'll select the yes, I agree to the terms and conditions, and then I'll scroll down on the page, and as you can see, you'll be brought to this complete your e-signature section. In this section, you'll need to enter your identifying information, and this is what will be used to validate your identity in order to perform the electronic signature for your application.
Entering identifying information in required form fields.
After completing all of the identifying information and verifying its accuracy, you can go ahead and select the next page button to move forward. You'll then be brought to the submission page, where you'll see your Medicare Administrative Contractor shown here as a label and the reason for submission shown below it as well. You can then scroll down on the page and see other information on required and supporting documents. And if you scroll all the way down to the bottom of the screen, you'll also see current uploaded documents shown as well. Any documents that you uploaded when you initially submitted your application will be shown here as a viewable label. And if you need to make any updates to your application at this time, you can still do so by selecting the previous page button. Once you reviewed all of the information and it is correct and accurate for your situation, you can go ahead and select this complete submission button at the bottom of the screen. At this point in time, a pop-up will appear on your screen notifying you that any documents that you have not digitally uploaded will need to be printed and mailed to your Medicare Administrative Contractor. And if this is not done promptly, your application will risk being delayed in processing. So once you acknowledge this, you can select the OK button. You'll then be brought to the Submission Confirmation page, where you'll be able to print this page for your personal records. Congratulations, you've just completed a revalidation application for an individual practitioner.